Hello guys, this is Revan from Digi Integrity. Today we are going to see some interesting tech news in episode 207. Oppo unveiled the ColorOS 12-inch China last month. Today the company has announced the latest version of its mobile operating system based on Android 12 for the global markets. At the end of the virtual event, it also shared the update of rollout timeline. Let's take a look at when the international variants of Oppo's smartphones will receive the fresh version of ColorOS. Huawei's Amazfit has launched three smartwatches, GTR 3 Pro, GTR 3 and GTS 3. These new unveiled smartwatches will come with improved displays, battery life and new features. Please click on the card on the separate video to know more about these features availability of these three smartwatches. OnePlus 9RT is confirmed to feature a powerful vapor chamber for heat dissipation, 600Hz touch sampling rate and a 7GB of virtual RAM. This handset is scheduled to be debuted in China on October 13th. OnePlus 9RT specifications include a Snapdragon 888 processor, 4500mAh battery, 65W fast charging support and a 50MP primary camera. OnePlus, a global mobile technology company, welcomed Bollywood celebrity couple Shahid Kapoor and Meera Rajput Kapoor as a brand ambassador for its OnePlus TV product category. The collaboration reiterates the brand philosophy of never settle while highlighting the company's vision towards building a seamless connected experience. Online tutoring company Byju's has stopped all advertisement featuring its brand ambassador and Bollywood actor Shah Rukh Khan amid the ongoing investigation against his son Aryan Khan in a drug case. According to the report, Byju's stopped all ads over the last few days after the company came under fire on social media platforms like Twitter. However, it is not clear if the company has dropped Shah Rukh Khan as a brand ambassador or not. Apple iPhone Software Edition 3 may sport a similar design as its predecessor. iPhone Software Edition 3 will get the same A15 Bionic chipset found in the iPhone 13 series. This device should be 5G ready with the same 4.7-inch display with a Touch ID button combo. Email scams are not a new phenomenon, and hackers and fraudsters are constantly looking for a new way of tricking unsuspecting users into clicking on malicious links and stealing their personal information and their money. In the latest such email scam that has been hit Gmail and Outlook, fraudsters are fooling users by sending them mails that impersonate supermarkets. This then fooled users enough for them to click on the links. Needless to say, they end up losing their money, private data or both. In fact, it appears that these fraudulent mails use very official looking brandings and emails in order to trick users into clicking on the links inside. When you open up a Netflix, you get a splash page that offers the different profiles available. It is a pretty neat feature, one that Android TV users have wanted for ages. Google has now revealed the personalized profiles like a multi-user support will be coming to Google TV starting next month. Logitech, a company that is popularly known for its peripheral products such as keyboard, mice, webcams, headphones and more. The company has now partnered with popular designers Pankaj and Nidhi to launch special edition K380 keyboard, M350 mouse and a special sleeve. According to the reports, PUBG sequel being made on an Unreal Engine a while back. While the studio or publisher has not confirmed any rumors or even the status of the game being in development, it is becoming more and more of a reality. According to the new leaks, the PUBG 2 on Unreal Engine 5 could be scheduled for a release in its 2022. GTA The Trilogy Definitive Edition of PS5 and Xbox Series will be available for €70 or $70, while the PS4, Xbox One and Nintendo Switch version is listed on the site with an RRP of $60 or €60. Samsung Galaxy S22 Ultra may launch in early 2022. This Ultra model is said to include a slot for the S Pen. The Samsung Galaxy S22 series will be powered by a Snapdragon 895 processor or an Exynos 2200 chipset depending upon the region. Realme RMX 3462 has appeared on the TINA certification website in China. The listing reveals images and some key specifications of this phone. Realme RMX 3462 is expected to ship with a 6.59-inch display, 5000mAh battery and up to 12GB of RAM and a 512GB of storage option. Vivo Y20T has been launched in India. The key specifications include a 6.51-inch HD+ display, Snapdragon 662 processor, 13MP primary camera, Android 11 OS and a 5000mAh battery. Vivo Y20T price in India is set for Rs. 15,490. Huawei has confirmed that it will be holding a launch event on October 21st in Vienna, Austria. At the time, it was speculated that the company may announce the Huawei P50 series to the global markets. But the upcoming launch event will see the arrival of the new Nova series of smartphones. It appears that the company may unleash the rumored Nova 8i and Nova 9 phones through the upcoming event. In terms of domestic cell phone operating system, Xiaomi's MIUI is very well-known one. Easy to use and rich in detail currently comes with an MIUI brands and Xiaomi and Redmi. According to the new reports, a Redmi MIUI interface may need to be differentiated from Xiaomi's MIUI in some detail, mainly adding by some of the brand elements. Nothing Wrist One smartwatch with transparent sides that exposes its inwards as the company's next offering, and it looks nothing short of a stunning. The Nothing Wrist One smartwatch will come with all the new fangled health and fitness tech, including a heart rate monitor and a step counter to keep up with the competition. This smartwatch will be powered by the Google's Wear OS, which should provide its owner all that they need to operate it and keep it connected with their smartphone. Oppo Reno 7 series will come with a largely improved camera setup. Oppo Reno standard version is set to come with a main camera that features a 50-megapixel Sony IMX766 sensor. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.